try and talk without the mic. If you can't hear me, let me know. I'll talk louder or get the mic if I need it, so. I understand this is your last class before the review for the exam, and you've probably heard from other people that are gonna have similar things to say that I do, but I'm gonna try and keep it interesting and a little bit more relevant to what I do specifically. So if you have questions while I'm talking, feel free to interrupt me and ask questions then. Definitely want it to be a discussion and get anything answered that you guys have. So, I'm from Bonner Springs, Kansas. Graduated from Bonner Springs High School in 2005. Graduated from the sports management program here at KU in 2009. Program looked a little bit different when I was in school than what it does now. It's great what they've been able to do to change it, but I was a sports management major and a business minor. They were not put together when I was in school. So did that, and then for my last semester when I had to intern, I interned at IMG Longhorn Sports Marketing here in Lawrence. So be honest, I was a little bit late to the game when I was getting my internship. I encourage you guys to do that early, but it ended up working out for me. Got in there and they did corporate partnership sales for the university here. So IMG College was technically the employer, but I worked for the university doing that. Got a ton of experience going on sales meetings, activating, kind of seeing what corporate sponsorships was all about. I had no idea what it was before I started. Did any of you guys know what that was before you had previous guest speakers in here that have told you? No, nobody knew. I did not either. So ends up that that's what I still do today, and I'll kind of tell you guys how I got there. But just a little bit of advice, there's a lot of things in sports management that you can do that you probably don't even know exist right now. So it's pretty cool that you get guest speakers in here to talk about that stuff. I wish that I would have had that so that I would have known a little bit more about what my opportunities were. After I finished my internship up at KU and graduated, I went to Austin, Texas and worked for IMG College down there at the University of Texas. So I was doing the same thing that I was doing at KU except for I was full-time. When I started working at IMG, there were 20 properties across the country. So kind of your bigger universities, KU, Texas, Kentucky, Ohio State, larger ones like that. My first year there, they got acquired by ISP, so they're still known as IMG today. But they had over 90 properties when they did that. So larger ones, smaller ones, lots of opportunities, lots of good networking. So that was really a positive for me. I started there as an office manager, which doesn't sound like a very glamorous title, and it wasn't. I was ordering printer supplies. I was making copies of contracts, really anything that they needed me to do. After my first year, I started being a partner service coordinator. So I was activating some of the accounts that we would bring in, kind of bringing those to life, helping our sales team do that. I was down there for 3 years. My first season down there working was 2009. For those of you that don't know, Texas went to the national championship in football in 2009. So I got to go to the Rose Bowl, got to experience that. Colt McCoy got hurt. They ended up losing to Alabama, which was a bummer. But coming off of 2008 at KU and winning the national championship in the Orange Bowl and going straight into that, Texas is obviously a powerhouse in football, so it was a pretty cool experience to be able to go see the Rose Bowl and continue that winning streak. So after I left there, I came back to Kansas City and started working for the Royals, which I've been there since 2012. Had a colleague of mine from my days at KU that had taken a job there and kind of reached out to me and said, hey, I don't know if you're interested in getting home, but we have this position open and I think you'd be great for it. So came home that Christmas, interviewed, kind of had reached my ceiling at Texas at the time, so took the job with the Royals. Started as a manager of client services there in 2012. Set up a little bit different in the professional sports space, and every team's a little bit different and set up than how they are at IMG with the college side. So at IMG, the sellers sold and they also kind of activated, and I was there to help with what they had to do. With the Royals, you have a sales team and you have an activation team. Once the sellers go out and sell, then the activation team activates. So we're the day-to-day contact. We activate everything from tickets, signage, print, radio, anything that they need. We're kind of their go-to person for that. So a little bit different than when I was in the college side of it. You definitely get ownership of the partners, those relationships, which was pretty cool to me. So did that, was a manager of client services up until December of this past year, and I got promoted to senior manager of client services. So been doing that, and then actually as of June 1st, I will be transitioning to senior manager of corporate partnership sales. So I'm going to go from the activation side to the sales side, which is a little bit scary for me. You have a little bit more pressure on you on the sales side of it, but I'll basically be going out, getting new business, making cold calls, reaching out to current partners that we have for upsales, and then passing it off to our activation team to activate. So a little bit different from that end. I'm used to kind of having control in that side of things, but we'll see how it goes. So you can see that just, back up here just a little bit. So in 2014, my boss who hired me left and went to the Mets. And my boss from KU, when I was interning at IMG, came over and now runs our department, Jason Booker, who used to teach some class here as well. So speaking a little bit later about connections and networking and things like that, it definitely comes full circle. So I know I'm very close with some of the other speakers that you guys have had in here, Tyler Epp, Matt Beatty, Nick Khalil, all of those guys that have been in here. It's a really small network once you get into it. So I encourage you as you continue through the program, definitely network with your peers and get to know them and as many people as you can, because that's what's going to help you get a job and help you get your next job. You might not know it, but somebody that you're sitting in class with now could be the one that helps you get your job in the future. So anyway, just kind of a quick background of me. If you guys have any specific questions on what I do, feel free to let me know. As we talk through this, you might have some other things. So kind of start with this. This is a photo of the stadium from this season. So we had the biggest renovation that we've had at the stadium since 2009 when we completely renovated it this year. That included the Diamond Club. If you guys have been out there, it's one of our premium spaces that they did, completely renovated. And then outside of that, just looking at the landscape of the stadium. Have any of you been out to a game this year? A couple of you? Good deal. Did you notice anything different when you went out there from previous years? No? All right. Well, I will say before I started doing what I do, I probably would not have either. So now I notice the signage at every venue, any stadium, doesn't matter what the sport is, what the event is, that's the kind of stuff that catches my eye. So when you look at this picture and see everything that's sponsored on here, you see Sprint, Price Chopper, Miller Lite, KCP&L, State Farm, all of that stuff, that's what we sell. We sell that along with the print, the radio, hospitality a little bit on that side, activations, experiences. So now every time I look at a stadium, I'm looking to see what sign they have and looking to see what's new. From our end this year, the Blue Moon patio in right field there was Budweiser for many, many years. If you guys have been out there before, you probably saw that. And then we also have a Boulevard smokestack that's up on top of the outfield experience there. So in the off season, we went away from Budweiser, who had been a longtime partner of ours, and went exclusively to Boulevard and Miller Lite, which Blue Moon falls under. So I know you guys had Tyler here a couple weeks ago, and he touched a little bit on their Budweiser partnership. So completely different across the street from us. When you go over to Arrowhead, all you can find are Budweiser products. It's very hard to find anything else. Our stadium's now the complete opposite. So we have Miller Lite products and Boulevard products, but if you want something from Budweiser, you have to search it out. So you can kind of see how the partnerships like that are not just the signage, but they impact things inside the stadium. So you can imagine that really hurt Budweiser on their sales when you think about all the Budweiser that was consumed at the stadium throughout 81 home games. They don't have that anymore. You can only find it in four stands in the stadium, and you really have to search for it. So a huge upside for Boulevard and Miller when you walk in, and those are products that you're going to have now that you might not have chosen before. So other big thing is the Price Chopper patio that you'll see there in right center field. They are a new partner of ours. We had previously been with Hy-Vee for 15 years. So if you guys have come out, you've probably seen the Hy-Vee gate that you walk in. Tons of signage. They actually had, if you drive by on I-70, it said Hy-Vee on the press box rooftop. Price Chopper does not have that asset, but if you walk in now, you're going to find Price Chopper everywhere. You may have bought your tickets for the game at Hy-Vee before, gone in and seen lots of displays for the Royals, things like that. You won't see any of that there anymore, but you will see it all at Price Chopper. Kind of a little fact on Price Chopper, just getting through the first quarter of the year for them. They shared with us that their sales have increased by 10% over this time last year. So we look at that as, and so do they, as a huge upside to their partnership. They were expecting to be on the high end, 5 to 7% up from their sales last year, and they're up 10%. So they attribute a ton of that to their partnership with us. If you walk into a Price Chopper, you'll see they've done a great job with all of their co-branding with us, and they have a partnership deal with Salvi. So you'll see billboards of him around. He went in the store, did a commercial for them, did some radio spots. An endorsement like that. So that's something that they do pay for outside of their partnership with Salvi specifically, but that's a benefit that they have of being a partner of ours, because if they were Hy-Vee, they couldn't go out and do that anymore. Other than that, we've had just some minor changes on signage, new partners that are coming up. The last couple of years, as far as renovations, Rivals in right field was renovated before the 2016 season. And Craft a Draft, which is in left field on the Lodgeville, you can't see it in this picture, was renovated before the 2015 season. So those are a couple of areas that we have partners on as well. I kind of want to share with you guys some of our partnership success stories. I think when you hear about corporate partnerships and you see signage and they talk about print and radio and things like that, they're pretty traditional marketing assets. But we have some partners that have done a really good job stepping outside of the box and getting creative on what they did with their partnership and how they activated it. And that's really what we like to see. It helps spread their brand, it helps spread our brand, and it gets people excited about the Royals and being partners of ours. So kind of walk through some of these. Kansas State Company, was a new partner of ours 5 years ago. They came in. So they wanted to do a steak promotion. At first, they wanted to go with George Brett. They weren't exactly sure what this promotion was going to look like, but they wanted to reach out to him. So we put them in contact with George's people, and they tried to get something worked out and unfortunately couldn't, so they kind of came back to us and were like, let's look at a current player. So they ended up going with Eric Hosmer. Does anyone remember hearing about or seeing the Steaks with Hoss promotion last year? Yeah, if you watched any of the games or on social media, if you follow Eric Hosmer on social media, he posted about it too. So basically what they did is they ran a six-week promotion, used lots of different assets, used their home plate signage that you can see on here, their social media, our Royals.com site. They had Eric, he contractually had to put out 5 posts for this promotion himself, but you go on and you enter to win a cookout with Eric and 9 of your closest friends. So you come to your house, Kansas City Steak will provide all the food and drinks, and then Eric comes to your house and does a cookout. So as you can kind of see on here, we promoted it, as I mentioned, through our social media, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, our homepage takeover on Royals.com, his post, and then that signage on home plate as well. So there you can see one of his posts right there. He kind of works with Kansas City Steak to come up with what they want the copy to be. So that's kind of what they had him put out, and then shows a little bit of the registration form over here for what we did to enter to win. As you can see down here, our results, there were almost 40,000 total entries. And then when you look at the unique entries, that means that almost 34,000 people entered just one time. So the total entries has some doubles up on that. And then the benefit to Kansas City Steak here is they had 16,000 people opt in to receive their newsletter. So if you're kind of looking at, you know, how does this help them? What does this do? This is driving traffic to their website, and it's also getting, 16,000 people that weren't signed up for their emails before, now they're getting them. They're getting their coupons, they're getting their emails. And they did it because they were excited to have a chance to have dinner with Eric Hosmer. So this was our single most successful promotion that we had done as of last year. So with the most entries out of anything that we'd ever done. I'll have to read through all of this by any means, but it just showed you some national and local coverage that this promotion received. So in return, Kansas City Steak Company and the Royals received that as well. So pretty cool to see it show up in the Sports Business Daily. There were several different articles that ran on it. It did a really good job with the activation side of this. So this is a quick video recap of the winner. So once they selected a winner, she got to have 9 of her friends come, lives in Overland Park. Eric came to her house, and they actually had a perfect setup for this. So in her backyard, they did the cookout, it was on the corner, a little bit private, but a couple of the news trucks showed up, and the neighbors started getting curious what was going on. So we had a little bit of a line of people out there towards the end, but did a pretty good job controlling the crowd with that. So. There were they all have on the same shirt, so it's a logo on there that they call Hot Haws, which is something that Kansas City Steak and Whiskey Design, who they work with, came up with. Just another way to extend their brand. So now they've got fans walking around with that shirt, and it's pretty cool because it's got this cool logo of Hosmer on the front, but it's got Kansas City Steak on the back. We actually did a giveaway at the stadium this year a couple weeks ago for our first T-shirt Tuesday that had that same logo on it, so fans were pretty excited about that. Another partner of ours who's done a really good job stepping outside of the box and on the co-branding of this is 360 Vodka, which is McCormick Distilling. They came to us actually after we went to the World Series in 2014 and wanted to create a co-branded bottle. So, you know, they want fans to come in, and from their perspective, if you know you don't have a preference on what you're buying and you walk in and this bottle has the Royals on it, you might be more likely to pick it up if you're going to take it to your tailgate or take it to your family, or you're just a big Royals fan. So they were a new partner of ours the year before, previous to the first World Series that we went to, and they created this first bottle. So they actually ran out. I don't know if it says on here when they first ran out, but they ran out within the first 2 months of this being out. They did a limited release on purpose to try and get people excited about it, which worked. So they ran out of that, and then in 2015 they did it again. As you can see, it has the world champions on there, and they did a higher amount, but they were still out in 3 months. So huge success for them as well, just kind of something that the competitors can't do. So again, if you're not a partner of ours and you don't have use of our marks, this isn't a bottle that another vodka company or another company similar to Kansas City Steak could go out and run a promotion like this. So. They did come up with this on their own outside of our partnership agreement, but everything runs through us and through MLB for approval. So again, had they not been a partner, they would not have been able to execute this. But another partner of ours, Commerce Bank. So Commerce Bank started doing a Royals card in 2014, and then they started reaching out to us and saying, how can we work with your other partners to help, you know, to help them and to help us with this card? So they kind of came to us and said, who are some partners that make sense? They came up with Rally House, Sonic, Subway, and I cannot think of the fourth one right now, but they had 4 different partners that they started with the first year, and they're like, if you go here and you spend money, they're partners of the Royals, we're partners of the Royals, you're going to get cash back on that. So once they started doing that and they kind of came up with their design for the card, they had the highest acquisition that they had on those cards. You can see if they doubled the Royals credit card acquisition in the 2016 season. So it took a couple of years to get up and running, but once they did it, that's what they want. So again, you can see that's driving traffic to Commerce Bank. That's getting people that may not have used Commerce Bank previously, but they see the Royals card and they want to carry that. They want to be able to present that when they're out. Another one, just kind of a different example, looking at some different partners across the board. Kansas Lottery, we do have a partnership with both Kansas and Missouri Lottery on this. So they have the scratchers tickets, they do a second chance winning. So they change it up a little bit every year, but last year you could do a second chance, enter to win. You know, if your ticket doesn't win, you fill out the back, you send it in, and you get a chance to win a dugout suite for for you and 19 of your friends. So they kind of did that, and they just want to get people excited about it, kind of out, again, just using the Royals brand to get people that maybe wouldn't have been out buying these tickets before to buy them. This is kind of a pretty funny, I guess, commercial that they did to help promote this when it came out last year. Chance, you know, hey, maybe I didn't win on my ticket, but I can enter to win a suite and go back and do that. So they clearly captured the audience that they were going for with that. This one, just a little bit different partner as well, Remax. They were a new partner of ours last year. We have some data that we're currently collecting on them, but being a new partner last year, we don't have a ton of stuff yet. This kind of just shows what they did with our brand. So again, they were able to use our marks, put our marks on their business cards, on their signs that you see in yards, on their email signatures as partner of ours. So several different ways that they could do that and just grow their brand with Kansas City, not only the Royals, but the city as well, and try and get people excited about it. So they did some co-branded t-shirts. They ran some promotions with their sales team. Again, kind of going back to suites, hospitalities, things like that. So. An opportunity that they would not have had had they not been a partner of ours. This is Old Dominion. They're a moving company. They don't do a lot of household stuff. They do more commercial things. But they came in and did our spring training moving day this year. So they've kind of done this with some different teams, and they're now a partner of MLB. But the success story for them that's not actually up here is you can kind of see on the social media side what they got anyway, and a lot of people don't know what Old Dominion is, so when you're kind of getting that name out there, it's helpful to them. But they actually, what you don't see in this picture and what they didn't tell you on social media is the Royals ourselves have a company that we've used for the last 20 years to move us to spring training that is not Old Dominion. And we explained all that to Old Dominion when they came in as a partner, but we said, look, we get it, we'll put some of our stuff on one of your trucks and send it out, we'll do the social media to push it, we'll get your name out there. And again, Old Dominion knew this was going on, but to the average Royals fan that's looking at this, they think Old Dominion's moving everything. So they got it down there, they got the stuff back, the team had a great experience with them, and they actually have moved away from the company that they used for 20 years to use Old Dominion for everything next year. So again, another benefit of being a partner of ours, they probably would have never gotten that business, and the people that make those decisions with the Royals probably wouldn't have ever thought about changing had they not come in and done that. This one is Farmland Bacon Day. So again, just kind of playing to what your brand is. They came in and had this bacon day. They were on the Saudi giveaway that day. They had a stand. They did everything in bacon. I mean, they've got a bacon jersey over here. They had a bacon slugger. They had bacon sampling. Everybody loves bacon. So they came in and had this whole day. They're going to actually come in and do it again this year and have some other ideas, but it was pretty crazy what they did. You can see some of their sample stuff down there, and then they included a coupon with their bobblehead giveaway. So a couple more here. Boulevard is is, as I mentioned earlier, they're not a new partner of ours. They've been with us for the past 5 years, but they did not have rights to our logos before. So if any of you have seen or heard about the Crown Town Ale that they came out with in 2014 after we went to the World Series, and then in 2015 after we won it, they could not have our mark on there. So they did a limited run. They still had a ton of success because people knew. They knew what it was. If you're in Kansas City, you know what Crown Town Ale is. But they could not put our world's mark on there anywhere. So that was something that they hated. They hated that they couldn't do that because they knew if they had our mark on there that would drive traffic sales even more for them. So they, as of this year, now have our mark. So again, it's just them and Miller. They have our marks and are able to use those on their packaging now. This is a sample. This PC Pills actually comes out to the market this week. So they'll be able to use our mark on that. They'll be able to use it on the apparel that's in their store. Kind of some things that they haven't been able to do before to get fans excited. Just kind of looking here quickly. So this is our marketing campaign for the year. Our department and our marketing department are two separate departments. Our marketing department markets externally for us, so the Royals brand, anything that you see with the billboards, with the players, with this raised Royal mark, that's not a partner, that's coming from our marketing department. So we have a different campaign every year. This year it's raised Royal. And just a couple examples of how our partners could use this campaign. We have these yard signs that are up here in the left-hand corner that we did this year. These other ones are kind of examples of what we could do, but KU Med using it on their baby blankets, or Commerce using it on their checks there. So a couple different ways that we can change that campaign up every year and keep it fresh, and our partners can use it as well. So again, just kind of talking about the difference. I think that's one thing we hear the most when we have interns coming in to interview or anything like that, is not really knowing the difference between the marketing department that we have and what we do. So we have partners that we sell to that we help extend our brand. So in that aspect, we are marketing for the Royals. Again, the marketing department handles all of our external marketing. They handle our giveaways, so our bobbleheads, our t-shirts, anything like that is coming directly from them. So big difference that I didn't know when I was kind of going through the process and what corporate partnerships are as well. But that's my little bit of piece of advice there too. We get a lot of intern applicants every year. We only have one for our department specifically, that's year round. And so my piece of advice would be, do a little bit of research and know exactly what you're going in for, and kind of on the company and the background of what they're doing. Because if we get somebody that knows what we do and knows the difference between the marketing department and what we are, then they're pretty high up on our list already. So you guys have any questions for me about anything I showed you, what I do, my path of how I got there, anything? Yes.
When it comes to like the decision to like limit your licensing of like your logo and whatnot, kind of talk about like the decision process and like, because I know you mentioned you're limiting like your partnership with beer now. So what's kind of involved in that process?
Absolutely. So we have a certain dollar spend level that we do. It kind of varies across categories. We eventually would like that to not be the case and have it kind of be a standard, but we look at it by category. So on the beer partners, the way that we have written it into our partnership agreement with Miller and Boulevard is that no other beer company can come in and have use of our mark. So for at least the next 5 years, you're not going to see any other beer that has our marks. Now, you will, and you won't see this with Budweiser, but you do run into situations where Budweiser has a deal with MLB separate from us, so they are able to still have access to some things. But you won't see Budweiser cans with the Royals mark on them like you do with the Chiefs, or like you have maybe for the Royals in the past. Same thing, you look at, we have a couple of different haircut companies, so Great Clips and Sport Clips, that are on a smaller scale, as you can imagine, from something like a Boulevard or a Price Chopper. So their spend level is a little bit lower on what it is, but we want to protect them, so we don't want to have somebody coming in for buying a printout and having use of our marks on things like that. So it really varies case to case on what we're doing. We do have a little bit of a threshold on that. And then the process of it, I mean, they get used to all of our marks, but everything runs through us and everything runs through MLB. So a partner sends me something and it has our mark on it, it doesn't matter if it's a business card, an email signature, anything like that that comes through. Because you're right, we do try and limit that stuff, and we are always on the lookout for things that are have our mark that shouldn't, that are unlicensed. It hurts our partners and it hurts us for the royalties that we bring in on that stuff. So that's why we've got to be careful, especially around the World Series the last couple of years when we were there. You could walk down the street and find Royal shirts everywhere that had a mark that was supposed to be ours that wasn't really ours, or a Royals mark that they got hold of. And you know, we've got to try really hard to protect our partners because that's a big deal to them. Again, 360 Vodka doesn't want some other vodka company coming in and getting their mark. So we write that into the partnership agreement, that they're protected, and that lasts as long as their partnership's there. So even if somebody came in and wanted to offer us double the amount of money that Price Chopper was, they in the grocery category, they wouldn't be able to get that. So that's kind of how we protect it. It goes through a lot of layers of approval when anything comes through to us. But yeah, just kind of depends case by case in the category what it is. Anything else?